Bitch give it slip. We gon' ball out to the max. Came up from nothing, we started from scratch. We gon' turn up to the max. Sit up on the floor, now I'm sleeping with blacks. We gon' ball out to the max.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Today we're going to be taking a deeper dive into the life of lilloaded and really exploring how he went from an overnight superstar to a gold recording artist to ending up with a really tragic and sad story in the end. There's a lot more to his life than you may know, so let's just hop in and explore. Dashawn Maurice Robertson was born August 1st in the year 2000 in San Bernardino, California. He had a rather large family, with having an older brother, older sister, as well as a younger brother and younger sister. His father wasn't in his life as he was in jail, but Loaded didn't want to talk about this much in an interview, so he only had his mother. At age 10, Dashawn and his family made a move to Dallas, Texas. He said in an interview that his older brother really helped raise him, and he taught him how to be in the streets and make some quick cash. As Dashawn grew into his teens, he became a lot more engulfed in the street life, which we'll talk about a bit later because it becomes a lot more prominent, as you'll see. Age 15 would be a really life-changing year for Loaded, as this would be the first time he would be shot at. When I was 15 years old, I was worried about playing flag football and basketball in the park with my friends, and it's just hard to believe that kids today have to worry about these same experiences at such a young age. And on top of that, Loaded's brother was tragically killed in street violence in the same year. Loaded said that he felt he could have done something differently if he was there, and that's just so hard for a 15-year-old to feel that part of their brother's death is on them because they weren't there to help them. There were no convictions or arrests ever made in this case, and Loaded himself said that he thought this was okay, and I likely believe it's because he didn't want any police involvement, which we'll see comes up again later on. After having to deal with losing his brother, life was a lot harder for Loaded now, and he felt that he had to provide for his family because without his father in his life and his older brother, he was the man of the house now, so he was the one who had to provide for the family. And school wasn't exactly for Loaded, as he would end up dropping out, and he would even end up dropping a song later in life called High School Dropout, which is a pretty good song. After a few years had passed and Dashawn was 18, his life was about to go through a whole nother roller coaster. Age 18 is when Dashawn was actually shot for the first time, and it's a pretty crazy story to hear, so I'm going to try to break it down for you. He said it in an interview with raptv, I heard. So he said basically, he was shot at and the bullet was going straight for his head, and he just happened to put his hand up, which blocked the bullet. The bullet got lodged in his hand, and like I said earlier, he couldn't go to the hospital because that would mean he would have to report a shooting to the police, and that wasn't for him. So he went to what he called a hood doctor, and she took the bullet out of his hand with absolutely zero anesthesia at all. So imagine being an 18-year-old kid getting shot in the hand. You just saved your life because you blocked the bullet, and then you have to get it taken out. No drugs to help the pain, nothing at all. Like, that's such a traumatic experience to have to go through. Loaded would later say in an interview that this had a very big impact on his mental health, and it caused him a lot of paranoia after the fact, which is very understandable considering he was shot and he almost died, but to him this just meant that he had to start moving smarter. By the age of 19, Loaded was associated with the Rolling 60s Crips. I don't know exactly what age he first joined, but by this age he was definitely a part of them. Nipsey Hussle is also a prominent member who you probably know. Around this time is when Loaded first began making music as well. He wasn't doing anything serious, but when he began showing his friends, they all told him it was really good and he should actually start trying to do something with it, so he did. In June of 2019, Loaded would post his first song to YouTube titled BOS. It would receive around 500 to 600 views in the first month, which might not sound like anything crazy, but for a new artist and their first song, that's something to be very proud of and very motivating. After this, Loaded was looking to make another song, and that's when he typed in on YouTube NLE Choppa Type Beats. This is how he found for the beat for Blocc Baby, and Tommy Craze was making a YouTube video.
Yo, don't sleep on these guys. Next we got lilloaded, Blocc Baby. One view, 54 minutes ago.
Hey, Kimmy on the block, baby, what? Kimmy on the block, baby. 32 shot Glock, baby, what? 32 shot Glock, baby.
Exactly 54 minutes after Loaded posted Blocc Baby on YouTube, it had one view, and Tommy Craze was making a series reacting to videos, music videos with zero views. He decided to look at Loaded's video and it went crazy. And I'll remember exactly, I was in my high school statistics class, very bored because we were doing statistics, and I was watching Tommy's video, and this is how I found Loaded. Once he started playing that song, I went crazy, and I just went and added Loaded to all my playlist immediately, and that's how I started following him. The publicity from Tommy's video would really help Loaded's career, as that boosted blocc baby to over 150,000 views very quickly, and Loaded said immediately after this interview that he had every single label calling him. To this day, blocc baby has over 50 million views, so it was obviously a banger. In the end, Loaded would decide to sign with Epic Records, and in the following months he would drop a lot of songs, including Smoke Today and Ops on Fire, which is actually my personal favorite song. Both songs have over 3 million views on YouTube today, so I would definitely recommend checking them out if you haven't. They're both amazing songs. On October 22nd, Loaded would post Gang Unit on YouTube. To this day, that song has over 57 million views and is his most viewed song on YouTube. And in December of 2019, Loaded would drop his first tape, blocc baby. Even with the growing fame, Loaded couldn't escape the violence, as he was in a fight with his friend EBK Cyrac in a Foot Locker, and it's a pretty crazy fight, so I'll show you all the clip real quick. Here you go. In September of 2020, Loaded would drop another tape, A Demon in Blue, before a very controversial situation would occur in his life. On October 5th, Loaded was allegedly recording a music video at his friend Khalil Walker's house. Walker's sister was inside the house when she claimed to have heard two gunshots and ran outside. She saw Walker lying on the ground with a gunshot wound in his torso, and Loaded and another man standing above him. Loaded took Walker and the other man to the hospital, but Walker was pronounced dead from his injuries at the hospital. Loaded dropped the other man off after and went to Florida before he learned about a warrant out for his arrest in Texas and returned and turned himself in. He was booked for murder but released on $75,000 bond. He would later be indicted on manslaughter instead of murder. After this incident, Loaded didn't release any new music until he dropped another mixtape titled Criptape in December of 2020. 2021 would be an awful year for Loaded, and he only released one song titled Bag Talk before the incident. On May 31st, Loaded's mom found him lying on the floor of their home with a gunshot wound to his head. She called 911 and the Cedar Hill department responded to an attempted suicide. When they arrived at his home, they found Loaded dead on the floor with a gunshot wound to his head, and it was clear that he had committed suicide. His mom would later say that she had seen him the night before crying and visibly upset about the love he still had for his ex-girlfriend. Loaded made one last post on his Instagram story the night before he died, and it's very hard to read, but it says, "Dear Most High, please forgive me for my shortcomings and all of the times I fell short of making you proud and being appreciative of the blessings that you have been put in my life. Sometimes the lines are blurred between being solid and being heartless. I want to thank you for how far I've come and the people you've put in my life to keep me grounded and humble through everything, and I love every single one of those people that are genuinely for me. I ask you entrance into your kingdom through all of my mistakes. I know you love all of your children, and I'm ready for my heart and soul to join you." Just reading this is really hard. You know he was going through a lot mentally, and it's just so hard to see this after the fact, knowing what ended up happening. Loaded's friend EBK Cyrac, who we saw previously in the fight, would also post a tweet after his death, which said this: "Loaded was going through a lot mentally during this time, and it is just such a sad story to hear. I personally used to actually play PlayStation with Loaded, and I remember I saw him on Instagram. He posted on his story, looking for some 2K players, PS4, hit me up. I slid up, and we ended up playing 2K and just hit it off, and Loaded was such a dope dude. One story specifically I'll never forget. We were playing Pro-Am, me, Loaded, and a couple of my friends, and we told him to rap, like, around the three-point line to get open, but we just said rap. And the man thought we were just talking about, like, actually rapping. He's like, "Don't worry, boys, I got you. I'll rap after we win this game." And it was just so funny. And that moment is just a great moment. And it's just a tragic story that we had to lose Loaded so early. But he's a legend, and he will live forever, and his music will always be a part of this earth. I really hope you guys enjoyed this style of video. I had a lot of fun making it, and I put a lot of effort into this. So if you could drop a like and subscribe, I'd really appreciate it. Make sure to let me know what other types of YouTubers and artists you want me to do this on, because I'm down to do it on almost anybody. Just let me know in the comments what you want to see. because it's a lot of fun for me to make. So yeah, guys, I appreciate you watching the whole video. Make sure to drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace.